Hello again from AC7AV. We're going to go over the assembly instructions. I haven't really wrote any instructions yet, but I'm going to show you here. So we have the beginning of the X beam. This is just the vertical pole that has the feed point and the hub. This is going to get shipped out assembled here, so you're not going to have to put all these pieces together here. So feed points, and the lowest one is loose on there, and so these are the center portions. All the support lines and the element wires you can see laid out here on the ground. Just makes it easier to put it on the antenna if they're kind of all laid out. So, we got a little rotor here. That's going with it. Probably a little underpowered for this antenna, but at least it'll get it working. All right. Put the hub in there. And we'll tighten that down later. So, you notice there's alignment marks here. That's important because there's a set screw right here that goes into the center mast to keep it from moving. I'm trying to do this with one hand because I need a GoPro. All right. And so you see this clamp on the number 6 meter element has been loosened up so that it'll fit down over here. So we got the hole already there. And as you see, it didn't really go down all the way. There is welds around in here that kind of went through the center a little bit that are causing it not to slide in there very nicely. But because I've already pounded it in there a few times, it's going to line up perfectly. So you just, after you set it in there, you just pick it up and tap it on the ground and you're good. Sets it right into place. And I don't know if you could see it in the video here or not, but trust me, the hole is lined up perfectly. All right. So we'll just put the set screw in there and call it good. All right. And then next thing is here, we're going to get this clamp tightened up. It's just a 5/16 nut driver for that. And you just want to make sure it's sort of in line with all the rest of them. And it doesn't really matter if it's perfect or not, but, you know, just keep it close. That's really it. All right, so it looks like everything's good. I'll get the rotor tightened up. You don't need to see that in the video, really. All right, so these are the fiberglass spreaders. You notice there is a hole here, and there are threaded nuts welded on to the center hub. That is just to keep it sort of locked into place so it doesn't rotate or anything like that. These came with the hub. Why not reuse them? And maybe they could be useful for something if you needed to tie something off. Anyway, they'll screw right in there if the hole's lined up. That way it won't move. And you can repeat the same for all the other ones. If you notice, they're all labeled. So this is spreader one, and they just sleeve into each other. It doesn't probably really matter if you mix them up, but just in case, you know, I did mark them all, but they're all measured out exactly the same on each one of the spreaders, including there is a small end piece in here that's just a couple of feet long that, again, sleeves into here, into the middle section. And, yeah, so that one's the same way. Now, for the final installation, I would recommend that you seal all these, whether you epoxy them because you don't ever plan on taking it apart, or at least silicone it over, waterproof it. Same thing with the end, because the end's going to be open and it's going to be pointing up. So that means water was going to get into it. So, you know, I would recommend that that you do that. All right, so I already showed you the assembly of this this first element, how they're labeled. All the rest of them are labeled, you know, whether it's 1, 2, 3, or 4. So we're just going to play this in its entirety just to show you how long it actually would take to assemble the thing. And, you know, of course, it only took, you know, a few minutes to put all this together, even in explaining it. Get this far. So the rest of it goes pretty quickly, but there's a lot of pieces to it, so it'll take some time. And of course, I just noticed I didn't put all the rest of the center pieces in, so I gotta go grab those and get those all installed in the hub first. And like I said, those are numbered. Probably want to make sure those stay in the right spots, because the set screws in there, they're not all in the same places on each one of the hub connections. Some of them are on the side, some of them are on the bottom, and they may not be in exactly the same place anyway. So once you get those in there, you can secure them into place. Either now or later, it doesn't really matter. It's probably easier to do it now. That way, if you need to twist it or anything to get the holes to line up, it'll be a lot easier before you get all the spreaders assembled and the wires on it, because that'll be a lot tougher then. Anyway, so all these spreaders, they have clamps on them to keep them from going in any further than they do. I don't expect those are ever going to move. So not that it really matters at this point, but you can tell which side of the antenna is the front by where the ballon box is and all the feed points. Those are always on the front side of the antenna. Now I'm just going to hook up the center support ice cords. Lost my audio. So these are not 100% required for the antenna to work, but in the wintertime, you're going to be glad they're on there. Those are going to keep this thing from collapsing under the weight of ice and stuff like that, wind, you name it. So I I even put heavier duty cords on this one than the one I use here. And these are the long ones that go out to the tips. So, we're pretty much done with putting the support lines on for now. We don't want to put any of the other ones on there because it'll make it quite a bit more difficult to put the elements on. And so we still have the flexibility of all the support poles on here so we can easily put the elements on. Now, when you get around to the installation of the elements, it is best to put them on, I've found, you put them on from the back of the antenna. That way you're not trying to like string it all the way around the antenna by connecting one end to the feed point and then pulling it all the way around. It's just easier to start in the middle and the rear and pull each side up around. So we're going to start with the 6-meter element, although it doesn't really matter which one you start with. I found that it just makes it easier to start with the 6-meter because then you're not trying to duck all the other elements as you're putting it together, if you happen to have it on a tripod like this. And you can just as easily put it together on the ground, or if you have a stepladder or something, you could pick it up enough to get to it. You know, it's nice to work on it at eye level, basically. I had to go grab the nuts that hold the elements onto the feed point. I forgot to bring those out, so I'll be able to get it all hooked up and together. Now, for the video, I'm just slipping the nuts on there, but when you get to actually putting this thing together, there are lock washers in the hardware bag. You'll want to put one of those on each one of the connections. That way they don't have any way to loosen up on there. And the lock washers actually do help to bite into the element and the post nut to make sure that it's really making a secure connection. Pulling the 12-meter element on now. Same thing. I'm standing in the rear. The front of the antenna is now facing towards the camera. So that's why we've sort of started in the middle rear. And we'll just pull them around each side. It makes it, like I said, a lot easier to do it that way than to try to string it all the way around. I just turned the antenna so you could see how I'm putting it on to the next one up. And, of course, they're in order. You don't want to mix them up. You don't want to cross the wires. Don't cross the streams. Alright. And so, as long as you didn't put any of the other support lines on the antenna, you should be able to connect all of these element wires up pretty easily. Because there's a lot of flexibility horizontal-wise in the spreaders, so you won't be fighting against them to put the wires on. You can wait till all the wires are on, then you're going to put the remaining support wires on that actually hold each one of the spreaders out to its form so it doesn't move around. All right, so we're already on to the 12-meter wire. Or did I say that before? So we got the 6, the 10, and this is the 12 now. And because I rotated the thing... Oh, I didn't do it on that one. Well, you'll see. The next one. I started stringing it all the way around the antenna. I forgot I had rotated it. I have put this thing together and taken it apart quite a few times in the last several days. Just making some slight changes and modifications to things. And just trying to improve how things hook together and work as far as the installation goes. I have had it completed for about a week or so, but just trying to finish up little details and stuff. I have put it together and taken it apart quite a few times. In fact, I had it purposely. I just wanted to see how long it would take to get it up on the roof piece by piece. Put it together, get it up off the roof there, about 10 feet or so, and do some actual testing on it just to make sure everything is where it should be. And it looked really good on the SWR testing, and I did a little bit of on-air testing as well, and seems to perform just great. In fact, I think it might be better than the one that I have here. Well, it better be, because it is better. This is the latest and greatest, and I think I have perfected the dimensions on there for best performance. Yes, this is a 15-meter one. See, I started stringing it all the way around. I forgot that I had moved the antenna. Normally, when I have it set up, I have the feed point facing towards the camera, but I had moved it for the video here. Just because it's a little bit more interesting than staring at my back while I'm trying to put each one of the elements on, so. Anyway, so, yeah, this is the latest and greatest X-Beam that covers the standard band, 6 through 20 meters. And so I think, the spreaders themselves from the center hub to the tip is, I want to say it's 13 feet, if they're sticking straight out. Now, this is bowed up. I haven't really tried to figure out what the calculations are on how wide it is. But actually, I could. I've got all the measurements of the support line. So if you want to know how long it is, just look at the upper long support line. That's exactly the turning radius. And since I don't have that notebook in front of me here, I can't tell you what that is at the moment. But you'll have that all up in the write-up. Anyway, it's just about the perfect day here today for putting this antenna together. You know, it's not super sunny bright. We've got a little bit of filtered sunshine, slight breeze, just to keep it a little cooler. And yeah, I'm surprised I haven't seen the dog in the video. He might be sitting in the car. I left all the doors open on the van because it just sort of keeps him occupied. He's happy to sit in there because he thinks that we're going to go to the dog park. But he might make an appearance here. Alright, so that's all those elements. right. I got to get the other side. And one of these days I'll get a better video camera for doing this sort of stuff. This thing is old, but it still works all right. It's just not high definition. Well, it sort of is. 720, I guess, is what it records. Only I have it in the widescreen format, so... Yeah, so that's the 17-meter element going on. Now, obviously, the 20-meter element's too high for me to get there, so I'm just going to set it on the ground. I don't know what it weighs with the rotor on it. It's not real heavy. Twist in the wire there. That's it for the elements. So, now you can't really see it in the video, but when you put all the elements on there, they want to pull apart the front of the antenna, so because they're all pulling in the same direction. So that's what this next piece is for, and that's going to tighten up everything. It's going to hold the antenna square across the face of it. So that pulls out all the slack out of the elements. There's another one for the inside also. Oh, these are the diagonal ones I'm putting on here now. And these ones here are an addition that I put on my big antenna too, that if if any of these types of antennas, even the common hex beams, if they were to become really loaded down with a lot of ice weight, it is possible, and maybe this is what happens to some of them that get damaged in the ice, is they can collapse in on themselves by twisting. And so these triangular lines that are going down to the center prevent that from happening. So the antenna is not able to twist. I mean, if it would really have to have a lot of weight on it before this thing's going to twist. Anyway, so you can see how much more rigid it is now, just even moving it around. We do have a couple more support lines to put on there to hold this thing nice and square. This is the inside front. Okay, we'll try that again. So this is the inside front support line across the face. So that pulls some of the slack out of the upper bands there, like 10, 12, 6 meters. And that one across the back is just sort of to make sure it's not getting pulled apart from the back from these triangular lines. So it sort of adds some rigidity to that part. So what I'm hooking up on here is another triangulated line on the back spreader, but it's going to go to the center front, and then from the back it's going to go over to the center rear. And that's basically to triangulate the rear spreader also. It's not really, doesn't really have any, it doesn't have a lot of pull on it or anything like that, but it's there just, again, for, adverse weather conditions. You know, like if it got really windy, again, it would help keep those spreaders where they're supposed to be, because the wires can slide through the D-hooks that are on there. And those will keep those rear spreaders from being able to slide on the wires if it became really windy and gusty. That'll take the weight on that and hold it to its form. Oh, there's the dog. I knew he was going to make it in there sooner or later. Probably got bored of sitting in the van. And you want to have those rear triangular supports, you want to have those on top of the elements. Otherwise, if it was underneath it, it's going to try to pull them up. So on top, so it's not trying to pull up on those elements. Anyway, so there you go. Less than 30 minutes. Fully assembled from the pieces. And here's the finished view. Some close-ups of some of the connections. All right, so here's the ballon box. I did put some notes on here. So this is the shield side. This is the center conductor side. That way the coax is connected up correctly, so the center conductor and the shield. If for some reason you ever have to take it apart, disconnect everything, you'll know which side is what. And here's a bottom view of it. I have since taken these wing nuts off. I just have some nuts and lock washers on both sides. And I didn't put the lock washers on here for testing, but like I said, they are in the hardware bag. So you can install those for the final installation. But I have insulated all these. This, the white cable, it's actually RG8X. It was just some stuff I had. They're all sealed up pretty well. Feel free to seal up anything. I mean, if you want to cover it all in silicone goop, weatherproofing, mastic material or whatever, feel free. I mean, because you can't over water protect this stuff. So if you want to cover it in whatever kind of goo you want to make sure it's going to last, you go right ahead. I did seal up the box, so that's why you can see a little bit of residue here. The box is sealed, and this is actually sort of upside down compared to what my antennas actually intended the box for. So there's a weep hole in the top. The weep hole has been sealed. So as you can see here, I drilled another one in the opposite side. So if water does get into it, it will be able to drip out. Plus, when you install this, you're going to need to definitely seal up this area because you're going to have the coax connector coming out of the top. A couple of screws. Seal the heck out of this with whatever you got. Something that'll keep all the water out of the coax, out of this connector, out of the box. So you're going to want to seal all that up really well. And same thing with these connectors. If you want to coat this all over in something so water can't get on it, I did put ox guard on all these threads, so you shouldn't ever have any trouble taking this apart down the road. Now, I have reinforced this a little bit, so I've got four D-hooks on here now, but this is just showing you how they were all connected on there. Now, after the final installation, just to make sure there's no chance of these hooks coming off, you can take a pair of pliers and crimp these hooks over so they can't come off. I've already done that on the sides where the ropes are going into, but once you connect them in there and everything's good and you're done with it, I would just crimp those over. That way there's no chance of them coming off. I mean, it's not real strong metal, so if you ever need to take it off, it'll be possible to do that. So, or you could just take the clamp off. Either way. And there it is out sitting in the rain. That was probably... that was before I went on vacation, so I had it actually already pretty much put together by then. And here it is up on the roof. That's when I was testing it out after getting it up on the roof there. So I know it's kind of hard to tell the size comparison because this one's sitting back on the far side of the garage. This one's in the front. So they don't really look a lot different size, but trust me, this is a lot bigger by this much on each side, because this is the 20 meter wire and this is the 30 meter wire. So it would actually only be from here to here, so you can get a size comparison. So this is, it's pretty much double the size almost. Doesn't that look pretty? Look at that. It just looks like a well-made antenna once all the stuff's on there. Just looks nice. I think that one'll do you for a long time, hopefully. Unless a tree falls on it. I can't guarantee anything then. But what I will say, you know, you get what you pay for, right? I'll guarantee lifetime warranty on it. How's that? All right. Anyway, so yeah, I guess that's it. That's the bottom line. So hopefully you have fun with it. If you have any questions on how to assemble anything, certainly I know you know my email address and phone number, so just give me a ring. AC7AV.
Almost 20 dB over 9. It will be updated to save on bicycle.